Well, charter schools are always, they always live and die based on how well they serve their clientele, because nobody's here because they have to be here. And if we don't serve our families better than the traditional public school would, they'll simply take those students back to a traditional school, which is often easier to get to. And frankly, the funding stream that follows those kids then leaves your building and goes to another. So in a very simple business sense, if we don't provide a better quality product, then we don't get to keep working. So there's always been a very positive sort of motivation there for us to have an excellent product and to keep our families here. Some of the chief things they'll share with you are about culture, about safety, about environment, about the way their kids are cared for, about the expectations that we have for their students that haven't necessarily been found in the same share in other traditional schools. Those are some of the things that we expect from our parents. There's a contract they sign that talks about their commitment, and it's non-binding, but it is an important piece that we have, where parents agree to have kids here on time and prepared for school and in uniform and support us with an at-home learning environment that's conducive to kids being able to get their work done at home as well.
Some of our charter schools are performing very well. We've got Belle Isle, Harding, Kipp. Those schools are performing very well, and they're kind of tough to get into. And you know, just like popular restaurants, everyone wants to eat at the popular restaurant. Everyone wants their kids to go to the best school. And sometimes, you know, some criticism is made about charter schools going after the families that are most motivated and the students who are scoring the highest. And you know, there's application processes. So if in a neighborhood, say all of the really motivated families and the really strong students are going to the charter school, you know, there's sometimes a feeling that the public school is, you know, the kids that didn't make it. I don't think we have that many charter schools in Oklahoma City right now to get that, but in many states I've read that happens, where there's a lot of charter schools in a city that they, you know, the city feels like all of the top students and the motivated families are being pulled to the charter schools.
I think, and I talked to my leadership team about this morning, I think that because you have collective buy-in from all stakeholders, it contributes to a greater level of success. Kids choose to be here, teachers choose to be here, administrators choose to be here, parents choose to get their kids here. So you automatically have a better, I think, launching point when everyone's chosen to be here instead of a mandatory attendance zone or you know, something like that. I think we're also very nimble. We don't keep doing things that don't work, and we try things that do work. But above all, we have flexibility with the adults in the equation. If a teacher, administrator, or support staff are doing their job, they get to stick around, and if they're not, then we encourage them to go elsewhere.